Enjoy your coffee.
Thanks, Noni. Crack of dawn, great coffee. Let's get to my first challenge. I'm here this morning. I'm about to interview a professional rugby player, Juan De Jongh, best sidestep in the game. He's played overseas. He's playing currently for the Wasps. I mean, what can I train this guy on? You know, he's going to train me. So I'm nervous, but I'm ready. I've got an opening link that I've prepared. I just hope I don't fluff it, you know.
One, action.
This morning, I have the privilege of interviewing and meeting a professional rugby player. One who they say has the best sidestep in the game. Let's go meet Juan De Jongh.
It was good. I'm happy with that one. I just want to do one extra one.
He has one of the best sidesteps in the game, but can he sidestep my questions?
But can he sidestep?
Let's see how Juan De Jongh starts his day.
Okay.
Action.
Today I have the privilege of meeting a Springbok rugby player, one who they say has one of the best sidesteps in the game. But can he sidestep my questions? Let's go start the day with Juan De Jongh. Juan.
Hey Dean.
Nice to meet you, man.
Same here, man.
How does a professional rugby player start his morning?
Yeah, for me, before any session, I have to make sure that I'm loose and nice and activated. So before we start any session, I would like to do a couple of stretches. I've got a band over here for you. Let's just show you a couple of stretches.
I walk into the room and Juan gives me the stretch band. Now, I don't stretch much, so I'm quite nervous.
Oh, I'm feeling this.
Then you just pull it out a little bit. Just open up your groins a little bit. Mm-hmm. So you keep it there like for 10, 15 seconds.
Mm-hmm. And I watch him, man. He wraps this thing like he's tying a shoelace. And I'm trying to get this thing right and thinking to myself, oh my goodness, what now? And we start doing like a swan pose. I was like, okay, just keep smiling for the camera while I'm stretching my leg over. So, well, I can tell you, man, I'm feeling fired up already. So what are we going to do now that we've warmed up?
After this, we're going straight into a little good upper body session. Obviously, I'm on a break, so I can't train too much here now.
No, well, but I'm down for upper body. I'm down for upper body. Let's do this. Let's do this.
It was nice, cool, but I think what would have been nice was if instead of telling him let's do this, you could have done to the camera, then just given the camera a little.
Oh, okay. Director stops me and tells me to bring the camera and the audience a bit more into the link. It's good constructive criticism, so to make realize that it's not just only you, but you've got to bring South Africa into the gym as well. Upper body strength training. Now that's more my thing. Let's go.
Let's go.
Now I'm getting amped because I'm like, okay, let's go. Only thing is, can I push as much as what he can? You've played in both the Southern and Normous Hemisphere in rugby.
Normous.
Nice. Before we get into the training, you've played in both the Southern and Normous Hemisphere.
Normous.
Normous. Normous. Can you hide Normous, your muscles, please? What's going on with my brain? I keep on saying the word Normous instead of Northern. I mean, those are two different words. Normous, Northern. And I just got to ask you, you've played in the North and the Southern Hemisphere. Which one's better?
That's a tough question. I mean, you've got the best of both worlds of both of them.
So you've had a baby girl in Feb this year, and that must be amazing. But I want to know, does that change the way you're going to approach your rugby and your sidesteps and your tackles?
Yeah, I must say, I've been privileged enough and blessed to have a little Emily that was born in Coventry. I mean, every day it's just a blessing for me to see it. Very strong. He came in very prepared. He asked me questions about personal stuff that of my career, of my achievements that I didn't even know he was aware of, and that made it very good and relaxed for me just to interact with him.
Finals, including Rio, which one of those moments stood out the most for you?
Yeah, I've been blessed enough to have a long career, a 12, 15 year career so far, and I've achieved a few things, and hopefully I can achieve more in my last couple of years.
Finally sitting down with Juan and having the conversation actually made me realize I can do this. You know, these cameras, these lights, these people around you, but it was really, really a conversation, and that's what made it fantastic. I think I actually have the gift for this. Guys, I get the chance to spot a Springbok rugby player. Let's do this.
Let's go. It's going to be a tough one. He looks like a strong boy, but end of the day, I think I can do more reps than him. I'm going to back myself.
This might look like, but he's just making it look like. Spotting a Springbok, man, who could ask for more? I mean, you watch them, you see them play, and now you're actually there, holding him up. Two more. I mean, that was the best part. Telling Juan De Jongh to give me two more reps. Beautiful.
Lovely.
This is magic.